Yep, ParaNorman. Honestly, I remember that, watching that movie from time to time. Still is emotional, a beautiful classic family horror movie with a little bit of crazy comedy. But at the end of the day, it did provide it a very strong and powerful lesson, my friends. Well, let's jump right into it, shall we? Well, my friends, now for the next one, ParaNorman, a movie that came out about 12 years ago. It is an American animated comedy horror film directed by Sam Fell and Chris Butter. The later director's debut, and written by Butter. I think it must be Sam that he's talking about. Produced by Luca. And, so many actors and actresses I know, even one of them who passed away this year many months ago. I recognize one of them too. It is the first stop motion film to use a 3D color picture to create character faces, and only the second to be shot in 3D. In this film, Norman Bancroft, a young boy who can communicate with the dead, is given the task of ending a 300-year-old witch's curse on his Surrey town. Yeah, I remember watching that movie. Beautiful work. Absolutely feckin' beautiful. Ah, here we go. There's the production line. Gonna need that one, and then I'm gonna need to do speak about the voice cast, which looks like it might be enough to do five or six at most, maybe seven or eight. I'm better, accountable friends. Let's see. It says here the idea of the film came from Chris Butter, who realized that the zombie films often contains a degree of social community, though making such a film movie for kids, it could express the challenges kids face growing up. Interesting. Production of the non of the stop motion animation features took place at local studios in Hillsborough. Not sure where that is. I think it's an American town, country, and city or town somewhere. The film was in production for 3 years, with the animation stages of production lasting about 2 years, in the beginning in late 2009. Rather than using traditional 3D format cameras, the studio has 60 Canon. Whoa, they must have used one of those special cameras that filmed the movie. Imagine agency Kennedy created the campaign for the film. ParaNorman is the first ever stop motion film to use full color 3D printers for replacing animation. Prize, which was Coraline, has this kind of work. The use of black and white 3D pictures, which sped up puppet production, considering allowing team to make the large number of puppet faces required for the film. Quite often, it's the stop motion movies that are more out there. Co-director Faye told the New York Time they're a little weaker than no hard to pin down. To be honest, this film is very strong in ways. Let's see. Perhaps this one might give them more of an idea. It said the idea came from Butter, who thought of making such a film for kids could express that growing up. So he wanted a film that could show the challenges of children and also give people a better understanding, most likely. Now, I might have enough time for three or four. So, pronouncements, it's time I use your machine. Pronouncements. Man, this place is burning up in here. I'm gonna need to get colder these days.
Call me Smith McPhee,
who played as Norman Bancroft, an 11-year-old boy, Mifid, who can speak to the dead. And looks like he... I think I remember you now. Alexandra. And it's Kurt. Kurt Walker, also known as Nightcrawler. It's good to see you again, old friend. He did pretty good at that one, as he, back in the day, and probably would have been not much older. Let's see, who's this guy? Come on. Dang it. I can't exactly explain his full name, but perhaps this can give his first.
Tucker.
Tucker. Ben's name is Tucker, but Neil Downers, Norman's 12-year-old overweight best friend. Good person. Very good. And honestly, I remember he owned a dog, but sadly it got cut in half by a car. By accident. Tragedy. Roadkill accidents like that. Now, who else did you play as, Mr. Tucker? Before I double check you. Ooh. Whoa. He was in Alvin and the Chipmunks. And I think I remember him doing the Buddy series as well, as one of the owners. Good to see you again, buddy. Now, who's this sister?
Anna Kendrick.
Remember her. She did works on Trolls and got a few other movies I didn't see, but she's a pretty good actress. Not bad. As Courtney Bannock, Norman's 17-year-old sister and a cheerleader. And trust me, sibling relationships are so complicated. Now, this one, I think I can pronounce no problem. Casey Affleck, who is the younger brother of Ben Affleck, Mitch Downer, Neil's 19-year-old brother and a jock who is the target of Corfee's affection, and no spoilers, even though it is kind of a little funny. Let's see, Christopher Meigs, please, who did Fish Links as Alvin, a 15-year-old bully. Ugh, darn muckle. We have enough for a few more. I think I remember seeing you somewhere before, but... Hey, I remember you. We have enough for two more, and luckily one of them I plan to do in honor since he died about many months ago. Hurry up, I'm burning up out here, literally.
Leslie Mann,
I double checked her. She was the one who played as Linda and a few other characters, and Jeff, who played as Sarita, hang on, that's Norm. She's Norman's and Courtney's symbolic mother. And Jeff, I don't know his second name, but he was the one who played in Wally and a few other good movies. And he is a strict, the one who played as Courtney and Norman's strict father, who is concerned about his son's well-being. Even... Yeah, I know. Guy may be a jackass. Rest in peace to the actress who played us. Played as the... As grandmother. Cook. And finally, Brandon Hill, Jobs Horkins, I think his name was, the deceased judge who accused Agatha for witchcraft and the leader of the cursed zombies. Yeah. This movie is an underrated, gorgeous classic. Made me cry. The music, outstanding. And, I think maybe you guys might want this one on behalf of me. I know it's probably going to give you a little long, but unfortunately I'm going to have to make shorts short enough so you get a speech about things. Ugh. Ads on the YouTube board. You think they advertise something like this? Hurry up! Oh, God, I hate these things. Hurry up! Sorry. Here we go.
My name was Aggie. I remember my mommy brought me here once. We sat under the tree and she told me stories.
Go on.
They all had happy endings. And then those horrible men came and took me away and I never saw her again.
Sometimes when people get scared, they say and do terrible things.
Just as much as they get angry.
I think you got so scared that you forgot who you are.
We all do.
But I don't think you're a witch. Not really.
You don't?
I think you're just a little kid with a really special gift. Who only ever wanted people to understand her. So we're not all that different at all.
What about the people who hurt you? Don't you ever want to make them suffer?
In a way.
Well, yeah, but what good would that do?
Yeah.
You think just because there's bad people out there that there's no good ones either?
Exactly.
I thought the same thing for a while. But there's always someone out there for you. Somewhere.
I just want my mommy.
I know.
I'm sorry, Aggie. She's gone.
I'm sorry.
That story you were telling, how does it end?
Well,
I think that's up to you.
On how it really ends, sweetie.
Is this where they buried me?
Yeah.
It's a pretty good place to sleep. Then you can be with your mom again.
At peace. Ugh. I waited that far to ruin that moment. But yeah, you get what I mean. That movie gave very good lessons for the kids. And maybe good lessons, maybe it should work for adults. And honestly, I enjoyed that movie so much that I would give it a classic, even though despite not being perfect, between 8 out of 5 or 8.5 out of 10. And honestly, if you saw from my tribute videos, I did pay homage to Brendan Hill, God rest his soul. And honestly, I miss you, man. Rest in peace, my friend. And I hope you guys enjoyed this video, because honestly, it's one that deserves to be remembered for all times. Don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. You can click on the link to watch it. And I got one last movie left of our dear friend, whose name spells of Beetle. Ciao!